In this video, we'll take a look at the potential of solar energy, one of the most flexible and fastest growing technologies available. In this lecture, we will discuss two technologies that extract power from the sun, photovoltaic and solar thermal technology. Photovoltaic technologies are getting cheaper very rapidly and are already comparable to energy from fossil fuels in some countries. Let's first take a look at photovoltaic panels, otherwise known as solar panels or PV panels. The light emitted from the sun is absorbed by the semiconductor materials in the PV panel. The semiconductor material converts the light's energy directly into a current of mobile electrons, which supplies electrical energy. The panel is connected to an inverter that converts the DC output of the solar panel to AC power and ensures maximum power to the grid. We can characterize the power of the sun by the irradiance, i.e. The irradiance is the amount of energy per second incident on the surface of the Earth per square meter and is therefore expressed in watt per square meter. In order to find the potential of solar energy, we can integrate the irradiance over a certain amount of time to obtain the irradiation of incident energy density, E radiance. The total energy potential, E sun, for a certain PV panel is equal to the product of the irradiation and the area of the panel A. The solar irradiance strongly depends on the angle of the sun with respect to the Earth's surface. The irradiance is highest for the locations around the equator and decreases toward the poles. The global irradiance data has been made available by organizations like Solaris and NASA. The efficiency of a photovoltaic system is equal to the energy output of the system divided by the energy potential of the sun. This includes semiconductor conversion efficiencies and the efficiencies of the system components like inverters, batteries and the cables. Most solar modules which are commercially available have an efficiency between 10 and 25% depending on the technology used. Solar energy is notorious for its low capacity factor. This is because the solar radiation strongly depends on the time of the day and the seasonal fluctuations. Especially in countries far from the equator, there is a lot more sunlight available in the summer than in the winter time. Shadow should also be considered, since trees and buildings can cast shadows that strongly influence the performance of a solar cell. In solar farms, panels can even cast shadows onto each other. This is important when designing a solar farm. In the following example, we want to calculate the energy yield and the capacity factor of the Gujarat solar park on the top of the west coast of India. The Gujarat solar park in India is one of the largest combined solar farms in the world. It consists of around 84 large-scale projects that currently have a combined nominal capacity of 1,000 megawatts. The surface area of the farm is 2,000 hectares and will assume a moderate estimation of 50% for the total PV system efficiency. First, we want to determine the annual average energy density. Therefore, we can use this map of the India, which shows the average yearly solar irradiation across the country. Here it is shown that the park receives a highly yearly irradiation of 2,100 kilowatt-hour per square meter. We know the surface area of the farm. However, this should not be confused with the area that absorbs the light, otherwise known as the active PV module surface area. We will take an active area of 24%. Ultimately, we will receive a yield of 0.15 times 2,100 kilowatt-hours per square meters per year times 0.24 times 2,000 hectares, which is equal to 1.5 terawatt-hours per year. In order to compare with other technologies, we can express the annual generation as the energy per total area. The energy density is then 1.5 terawatt-hours divided by 2,000 hectares, which is equal to 75 kilowatt-hours per square meters per year. Finally, we can calculate the capacity factor by dividing the energy yield by the installed capacity multiplied by the hours in a year. This results in a value of 0.17. Let's now look at solar thermal technology. For solar thermal energy conversion, light from the sun, is absorbed by the panels. The liquid within these panels are heated up and go through a heat exchanger where it will warm up cold water. In rooftop applications, solar thermal technology essentially replaces some of the energy that you would otherwise use to heat up your boiler. When you proceed to a large scale, this technology can be used to generate electricity as well. Parabolic solar concentrators like these use a large area of mirrors to concentrate the light to a small tube. The liquid from these tubes will become hot enough to boil water. Next, a conventional steam turbine is used to generate, for instance, electricity. Concentrated solar power towers have also been around since a couple of decades and are becoming more and more economically feasible without subsidies. They use the same principles as the parabolic mirrors, only in a much larger scale. Some new concentrated solar power towers use molten salt as a working liquid, which can heat up to more than 500 degrees Celsius. A very big advantage of these salts is that they can be stored and the heat can be utilized during the night to produce electricity. This makes this type of solar power more continuous and can deliver a much higher capacity factor. Just like PV panels, solar thermal technology converts sunlight into usable energy. Therefore, the calculation for the energy potential is the same. However, instead of directly converting sunlight into electrical energy, solar thermal technology converts the energy in the sun to thermal energy. This means the system is very different. For solar thermal, the efficiency losses are, for example, caused by thermal conversion efficiencies, pumping and heat exchange efficiencies. In larger scale plants, there is also the turbine and the electrical conversion efficiency. Considering the energy yield, solar thermal power plants show the same issues as PV plants and is mostly dependent on the amount of sunlight over the year. For this calculation, we'll look at a personal rooftop. For the sake of comparison, we will take the same values as for our example with the PV technology. Therefore, the irradiation is 2100 kilowatt hours per square meters. However, our solar thermal system has an efficiency of 60%. This means the yield is 2260 kilowatt hours per square meter. This is considerably larger than the power density from solar PV. However, this application of solar thermal technology can only be used to heat up water. Small-scale PV technology has more applications, since electrical energy is much more useful than thermal energy. We have looked at both solar PV and thermal technology. We may conclude that PV is the most adaptable out of the two. Let's look at some advantages and challenges of PV technology. First, it should be recognized that the energy potential of solar energy is more than 1,000 times the average global power demand. PV technology is also one of the most flexible technologies in terms of scalability. Furthermore, PV technology can be a sound economic investment. However, one of the biggest challenges of solar is its dependence on the weather and the seasons, which results in a low capacity factor. The daily sudden drops and rises in power can especially be quite troublesome towards the grid stability. Although solar energy is one of the smallest contributors in sustainable energy, it is the fastest growing energy source. A recent trend is that every 2 or 3 years the installed capacity doubles. Thermal concentrated solar power only contributes about 3% of this capacity. According to the International Energy Agency in 2016, PV systems around the world would have produced close to 375 terawatt hours of electrical energy. Globally, per person, this results in a daily yield of 137 watt hour per person. Finally, small PV systems for domestic use can power densities ranging from 10 to 25 watts per square meter. Of all renewable energy technologies, solar energy therefore requires the smallest surface in order to fulfill the global energy demand. In this video, we discussed solar energy conversion. It is recognized for its enormous primary energy potential, being the fastest growing renewable energy technology. However, its low capacity factor requires a storage support. Next lecture, we'll look at a renewable energy technology that provides storage options. biomass.